can define a leader. He should have vision and passion and not be afraid of any problem. Instead, he should know how to defeat it. Most importantly, he must know how to work with integrity. A quote by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Hello everyone, I'm V.Brahaand of class 9 from Kendra Vidyalaya in Chennai. Here to talk about how better you deal with pandemic as a leader. To start with, I have a lot of questions in my bag of questions, and I'm sure that most of you would also be having the same questions. For instance, what's the role of a leader in governing a nation in spite of pandemic situation, like the one that's prevailing? And what are the major traits of a good leader? But these questions seem to be very simple, isn't it? But the simple questions are the toughest ones to answer. And now, I will be explaining whatever I'll be saying through hypothetical examples. And I want everyone to correlate these examples with their day-to-day lives so that they can experience it in a better way. Now let's take a hypothetical example. Let's say that I am interested in getting vaccinated and I also registered myself through our visitor app. And also, I fall in the age group that needs to be get vaccinated. But I just need to know the FAQs of vaccination, right? That is, when I should get vaccinated, how I should get vaccinated, and by what means I should get vaccinated, or even why I should get vaccinated. And if the government fails to answer even one of these questions, then it's not going to be a good governance, right? And how can I get vaccinated then? But I should answer these questions because I'm going to be a leader and I have to answer these questions now. What should I do? It turns out to me that I can also arrange locomotive vaccination. That is mobile vaccinator. That is mobile vaccination. I can also do that, right? But why are we not able to do so? But remember, the government is also having all the details of ours. I just don't need all the details, but most of the details. Let's say the Aadhaar details, the PAN card, let's say the ration card, etc. It's having a lot of personal details of ours, and thus it would be able to locate us within seconds. And not only that, it would also be able to personalize our way of thinking in a better manner. Let's say through technological improvements such as our visitor. But I'm not going to be at ease this time, right? Because if I don't even know the answer to even one of these questions, I'm going to be at disease and that's going to be a acrimonious situation for me. Now what should I do? Now this turns out to me that should be a good vision for a good leader, right? Good vision not only talks about a good eyesight, it also talks about the pre-planning and the organization of a good leader. Now, I just want to move a little back about what I said. I just said that we are a lot transparent to the government, right? But is the government in the same way transparent to us? I just want everyone to just think about this, which I will be answering in the meanwhile. Now, let's return to the vision of a good leader. Now, moving on, if I just want to solve my problem, that is getting vaccinated, I can provide locomotive vaccination, right? That is mobile vaccination. What can you do so? Now I'm going to put a statement up here stating that everyone will just get vaccinated within seconds if they just poke in their RBS data. Oh no. But how can I be saying this? Is it even possible to do so? Yes, of course. Because everyone are able to just book their cabs or even whatever the transport they want in within seconds in their fingertips, that is with their mobile phones. But why can't we do the same through our the app and all the other technological developments that we have? Of course, we can do that. This is one of the good vision that a leader should have. And of course, I guess I would be having if I had been a leader. Now let's move on to the next part, which I said I'd be discussing, that is the transparency of the government. Now I'll be explaining this through hypothetical example. Let's say there's a village, a remote village of course, there's no hospital there, only some small clinics, and even the educational system of that is not that good. What will the people do if the pandemic was hit up that way? And now the news has also come that COVID cases there are increasing. What will they do? And that's also another statistic stating there's only a city about 10 kilometers from this particular village. And there's no good road system up there. What did the government do? And now, after an hour or so, the government announced, stating that there's going to be a big hospital built up there in a massive scale. And as there were a lot of arable lands, farmers from around India are going to get transferred to this particular remote area, and they are just going to start their farming work. But it's just leaving me, everyone will be happy about this news, right? Why is it so? Because we all know that this village is going to get developed, it's going to get civilized, and in this way there will also be opportunities. But I'm not happy about it. But why? Isn't it a big breaking news for everyone? It's because the government hasn't been transparent to us. But how? If I had been participating in the decision making, I would say that this wasn't a good decision. Because about 10 kilometers away, that's a massive city. And they had built this 30 crores project up there, and only a good road system was built from that city to this village, most of the budget could have been saved. Right? And just improving its education system and just improving some non-farming activities would have been better. Because farming activities is labor absorbing, and I'm not going against it. I'm just saying that in this pandemic situation, just doing non-farm activities would be better than going for farming activities. And developing it will also take a lot of time to do so. Now, from this we have just learned that transparency of the government is also very much important. It's a key feature for a leadership quality. Because if we had been participating in parliaments and those decision making, we would have been knowing how to do so. Alright, so moving on to the next part. Let's take some examples from other countries too. Let's see China. Do we know that China built a hospital for that large population within a span of 10 days? How is it possible? Isn't it a lot plausible than being possible? Yes, of course, but still we have to talk about its reality. We have a lot of hospitals in India than most of the countries, but still we are not getting that much development in a country. Why is it so? Being a leader myself, what shall I do? Technological development is of course important, but still, what should we do? Now, what I'm going to talk about next is going to be a lot more breaking news than the previous one. I'm just going to state that there's a process of 4 stages in a country. This is stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, and stage 4. And stage 1, we have been doing a lot better. Yes, because it was our first time. But stage 2, something went wrong. All of the things have gone topsy-turvy. What should we do now? So, it just seems like the incident of APJ Abdul Kalam, right? But I'm not here to talk about it. I'm going to talk about a scenario a bit different from that one. That is, we have to implement emergency actions right here. That is, to put a final line in the coffin, I just would say that emergency actions would just lead to hyper developments of a particular sector, let's say technological sector. So if the stage 2 has just come, we have to implement a lot of things thick and fast. That means if you are developing a particular, let's say a technological app, you have to do it fast. And doing it fast, just ordering it is not going to be enough. Integrity in that is also going to be one of the most key features in that. As one of the APJ Abdul Kalam's quotes say, if you just fail to do second attempt, more lips are just waiting to just say that your first attempt was just a luck. Alright, so through this, I just want to conclude in a simple way that a good leadership always determines to have a good quality, such as having good vision, having good quality such as transparency in government and all that. Thank you, and have a nice day.